Hi, this screencast will guide you through the creation of an e-portfolio. In order to create an e-portfolio, navigate to your homepage on Digication and click the green Create button located on the right of My e-portfolios. On a new page, enter the title of your portfolio and select one of the templates listed. Templates are a quick way to set up sections and pages on your portfolio. It's suggested that you select Create from Scratch so that you have full control over which pages and sections you want to add. Next, you want to choose a theme. Each theme provides a different look to your portfolio with different color schemes and fonts. You can use the default theme on the template, or you can click on More Themes and pick from a list shown here. Click Select to choose the theme that you want. Next, choose the privacy settings for your portfolio. There are three levels of privacy for an e-portfolio: viewable only to you, viewable by Northeastern users only, and viewable by anyone who comes across it on the internet. It is suggested that you select Private to Me to start. You can come back and change this permission when you are ready to share your ePortfolio. You can also choose to allow tags for your ePortfolio. Tags make it easier for other users to find and navigate to specific pages in your portfolio. They can be added to individual pages in your portfolio after you create them. Click Create New ePortfolio to finish. These settings that we just went over can easily be changed by selecting your portfolio and clicking Portfolio Tools on the top right and choosing Settings. With the basic layout of your portfolio set up, you can go into your portfolio and add sections and pages. If you navigate to your menu bar and select the tab titled Add/Edit, you can insert new sections into your portfolio. Click Add Section. In a new field that opens up, enter the name of your new section. If you click Show Advanced, you can change the hyperlink to your section. You can also choose to hide the new section if you wish to wait to publish it at a later point. This is helpful if you have a lot to edit in a new section, or have edits you wish to roll out over a period of time and you do not want viewers to see your unfinished section yet. Click Save to finish adding your section. Now that you've added a section, you can also add pages or subsections to each section. Selecting the Add/Edit tab in the sidebar over here will allow you to do that. Select Add Page and enter the name of your new page. The advanced options here also allow you to enter your own custom link. And to hide it from viewers. In addition, selecting Collapse will provide an arrow for you to show or hide all subpages under this page. Checking off the heading option will not actually create a page, but rather a non-clickable heading in the sidebar. This lets you organize pages in the sidebar under different headings and subheadings. Click Save to add your page. For the next step, let's go and add several more pages. After you have created several pages, you can rearrange them in a sidebar by clicking and dragging the page titles. Subpages can be created by first dragging a page under the one you want to nest it in. Then click and drag the page to the right. This will nestle the page under the one above it and create a subpage, as you can see here. Now that you know how to create a portfolio and add sections and pages, you're ready to go and fill it with content. Watch the screencasts titled Adding Content Modules and Using the Rich Text Module to learn how.